we're down in the garden there, and we're looking after these tubers, and we're digging them up, and we, you know, we're separating them, and we're looking at them and harvesting them, just with our hands in the earth. You know, you can't help but think of old people. You really can't. It just brings you so close to them, I think. You know, you're working with a plant that they worked with, and you're doing it in a way that is similar to what they did. So you're really honouring them. And food's a story that connects us all. My name's Nathan Ligon, Yuin man, with some Wolgal connections up to the Snowy Mountains as well. Today we're down at Yumbra, or Black Duck is what we call the farm. We're on the Wallagara River, just over the Victorian border, Bitterwell country, in the southern part of Yuin Nation. Black Duck Foods is a social enterprise for Aboriginal people, particularly for country and the broader Australian and world community. We're really interested in our native bush foods from all around Australia, our yam daisies, the murnong, some of our lily species, chocolate and vanilla, whatever medicine plants, some kwandongs and other things. We've got a few different grasses that grow, kangaroo grass, dancing grass, and the spear grass. A day in the life at Yumbra it's always different. Over that summer period, we're really intensively focused on our summer grasses and harvesting them. At the moment, we've just done a lot of propagation work of raising seed stock. So now we're, you know, preparing some beds to plant those into. Yesterday, we put some fire on country. So we're trying some cultural burning techniques, looking at what the results of that will be in the future. Well, from the grains, we can make flour. It's got a sort of woody, nutty sort of flavour, a little bit smoky because they used a bit of fire in the processing of it, which is interesting. As for the yams, the other day we were able to harvest some and we fried them up with some butter in the pan and they were really tasty as well. I guess in the broader context of just being an Aboriginal organisation, trying to achieve this massive vision in a sort of colonial world is probably one of the hardest challenges. For me, I can't wait for the day when Aboriginal people are enjoying these foods again, can find good health and good spirit through eating these foods that Mother has provided for us thousands of years. At the most rawest, the connection to country, it just tells us what it is to be human, I think. We're a part of this earth, we're a part of this world, and we can't live separate from it. And you know, that's the same for the butterfly over there to the mightiest eagle. You know, they all find their home on the earth. Yeah, you know, that eagle, he nests in the tallest tree, but that tree's got its roots firm in the ground. So connection is so vital for our well-being, our mind, our body and our spirit. Our cultural values here on Yuin country tell us that Ngardi comes before Tunku, the woman comes before the man. So we've got a vision of supporting a group of women here on Yuin country, down on the farm, working with these plants as they're meant to be. It was a couple of months ago, myself, Terry and Chris went on a seed collection day, and we went from the coast all the way up to the foothills of the escarpment just collecting seeds of a particular lily species. You just see that once you've got an eye for it, this food is everywhere, you know, and it doesn't need much of a help to grow it. Mother's doing all that. So I'd say we're not growing anything here, the earth's doing it all and we're just helping it along.